Welcome to Basic English Class, Chapter 2, Classroom English, Unit 1. So what do you understand the title, Classroom English? English, which is used in the classroom, is called Classroom English. Then what kind of English we use? Specifically, the expressions, words, or phrases which are used commonly in the classroom by the teacher, by the students, is called classroom English. Whatever the expressions are, words, sentences used by the teacher. For example, good morning, students. That means greetings, related to greeting. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever it is. And simultaneously, students, good morning, sir, good morning, madam, good afternoon, sir, good afternoon, madam, in that way. Please sit down, stand up, answer to this question. This kind of sentences, expressions, phrases, words are called classroom English. So, in classroom English, some expressions are instructions, some are sequencing, related to sequencing, some expressions are related to supervising, some expressions related to asking questions, some related to replying questions. So, in this way, these are the some model situations. Okay. Take the one example of greetings. What kind of expressions we use? Just now I explained. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening. Good evening, everybody. Good morning, everybody. Hello, everyone. Hello there. Hello, Suresh. Hello, Naresh. In that way. These are the expressions related to greetings. Next, some greetings related to some expressions related to however, why, what, how are you? So, how are you today? How are you getting you? How is life? How are things with you? In that way. Some expressions, classroom expressions related to introduction. Introduction means this is only second class to you. Maximum 99% I have not seen you. You have maybe in the first class, some of you, maybe electrical branch students have seen me, but remaining have not seen. So, in the first class, we introduce ourselves. Generally, we introduce ourselves. So, suppose if the teacher introduces, the method is, the model introduction is, my name is Niranjan. I am your new English teacher or lecturer. I will be teaching you English this year. I have 4 classes each week. That means each time, if it is classified into 2 parts, each time 2 periods, I will come 2 times in a week. In that way. Next. At the beginning of the class, beginning of the lecture, beginning of the explanation, something. What kind of expressions, model expressions we use? Let us begin our lesson now. Is everybody ready to start? I hope you are all ready for your English lesson. I think we can start now. Now we can get down to work. So these kind of expressions, any one, we can't use, we don't use all expressions in the same time. According to the situation, we use. Okay, any one of the said, we use. And next, one more expression, situation, that is waiting to start. I would like to start. I am waiting for start the class. I am waiting to start the class. Yes, I am waiting for you to be quiet. We won't start until everyone is quiet. Stop talking and be quiet. Settle down now so we can start. So here you understand that these expressions generally we use while the students are not concentrating in the class. The teacher is ready to start, but students are not ready to listen. At that time, teachers use these kind of sentences or phrases. Next, put your things away. That means this is the situation. In this situation, the teacher is going to conduct one slip test, or he is going to ask questions orally, or is going to stop the class, whatever it is. So put your things away in this category. Some modal expressions are teacher's expressions. Close your books. Put your books away. Pack your things away. In that way. Next, related to attendance. Related to attendance, the modal expressions by teacher. Who is absent today? Who is not here today? What is the matter with you? What is the matter with Suresh today? What's wrong with you today? Why were you absent last Friday? So this is the thing. Next situation is late. Sometimes students come late to class. Then teacher uses some modal expressions like this. Where have you been? We started 10 minutes ago. What have you been doing? Did you miss your bus? Did you oversleep? Don't let it happen again. Okay, these are the some modal expressions. Now, I hope you all understand what is classroom English. By understanding, by observing all these examples. Okay. Now, I would like to ask you, how do you ask permission to enter the class? I'm giving to you, maybe some, if I say one modal answer, may I come in, sir? Shall I get in, sir? Excuse me, sir, may I come in, sir? In that way. Okay, here I would like to clarify one thing is, in this chapter, you have two parts, two points. One is student point of view, other one is teacher point of view. So in your examinations, questions will come like this. Write two modal expressions used by the teacher in the class, or write two modal expressions used by the student in the class. In this way, or they give the situation. Ask the teacher to permit into the class. How do you ask permission to enter the class? In that way, the question will come. So the same way, how do you ask permission to enter the class? The answer is obviously, excuse me, sir, may I come in, sir? Shall I get in, sir? In that way. Next, how do you greet your teacher in the morning? Everybody knows. Good morning, sir. Good morning, madam. Teacher means madam or sir, whatever it is, whoever it is. Next, activity. Look at the following conversation between the students and the teacher in a classroom and enact it before answering the questions that follow. This is not actually, this activity was designed for the purpose of practicing in the physical classroom. But we are in the online class. So this is not possible to enact in the classroom. So just we follow, we move on to the next step by step. So see, I read two roles, teacher role and student role. First, teacher. Good morning, students. Good morning. Just one second. Here, what you have to do is look at the following conversation between the students and the teacher in the classroom and enact it before answering the questions that follow. That means you are going to get questions from this conversation. Okay, be ready. Okay, teacher, good morning. Students, good morning. Teacher, ready? Students, yes. Teacher, what were we discussing in the last session? Can anyone tell us? Ananda, tenses. Teacher, good. To be precise, which tense? Students, past perfect tense. Teacher, very good. Now let us start discussing the next tense. Look here and try to identify the verb in these sentences. So the teacher writes the following sentences on the board. One, I had been living there for 4 years. Second, she had been working there for 10 months. Teacher, Ravi, can you come over here and underline the verb in the first sentence? Ravi, yes, I can. Ravi underlines the verb. Teacher, very good. And Vani, can you come over here and identify the verb in the second sentence? Teacher, finding Vani nervous. Come on, don't be nervous. You can do that. Vani gets assured and underlines the verb. Teacher, that's very good. Now open your books at page 10 and complete the task at the top of the page. A few students, sir, please repeat the instruction. What you said was not clear. Teacher, what I said was open the books at page 10 and complete the task at the top of the page. Now questions. What does the teacher mean when he says ready? See? Where is ready? Yes. Seat. Ready. So now, ready means the teacher wants to start the lesson. So here ready means it is time to start the lesson. Next. Second, can you guess the meaning of here in look here? Okay, I will tell you answer. Look here means to look at the board. Next, third one. What does the teacher say to help Vani overcome her nervousness? I will tell the answer. That is, teacher encourages Vani by saying, you can do that, and also help her to come out of her nervousness. Next, what do the students say to request the teacher to give the instruction again? The answer is, the students requested the teacher to explain it once again as they could not understand it. Okay, next, activity 2. Look at the following expressions and say whether they are likely to be used by the teacher or the students. Here, there is no confusion. I am going to give you some modal expressions. You have to identify which expression is used by teacher with generally used by teacher and which expression generally used by student. You have to identify it and write it. Okay. See. Copy this in your book. You tell me generally who uses this expression. Definitely teacher. Okay. Next, don't start yet. You can start now. Obviously, this is teacher. Next, can I talk to my partner as we do this? Yes, the answer is student. Next, how many letters can we use? So this is also used by the students generally because the student is asking clarification. Next, go back to your place. Yes, definitely it is teachers. Please give some more examples. Student. First listen and then repeat. Teacher. Set it down. Let us not waste time. Teacher. Next, activity 3. What are some common classroom expressions used by students in the class in the following situations? So here some situations are given. According to the situation, how the students respond, use modal expressions, we have to write. Yes, greetings. Generally, in greetings, we use good morning sir, good morning madam, good afternoon sir, good afternoon madam, like this. Second one, ask for permission to leave the class. How do you ask permission? Could you permit me to leave the classroom, sir? Could you permit me to leave the classroom, ma'am? In that way. Next, ask the teacher for a clarification. Generally, the question is that as modal expression. Could you mind tell me one more similar word for it in my mother tongue? Sorry, this sentence was by mistake entered. Sir, if you don't mind, could you please clarify it? Here, what you have to do is, you have to write this sentence here and this sentence here. Okay, answers. Next, ask the teacher for a similar word in your mother tongue. Could you mind to tell me one more similar word for it in my mother tongue? Next, ask the teacher to extend the deadline for a submission. Submission of a record, submission of notebook, submission of assignment, whatever it is. Could you please extend the deadline for submitting our records, sir? In that way. Next, activity 4. Guess the situations in which they are used in the class. So in the examinations, the question will come like this. That is all for today. In which kind of situation, where we use this expression by the teacher. So that's for, that is all for today means at the end of a class. The class is going to end. The teacher is going to stop the class. Next, how do I say that? So when the student is in a confusion, that means finding for appropriate words to answer. Next, teacher side, how many are absent today? So this question will come to know the strength of a class. Next, what is the Telugu word for it? Teacher, student side. So to know the meaning, this is. Next. Were you present on that day? Generally, the question comes when the student is not able to answer. Student did not answer the question. Let us start the lesson. That this expression generally teacher uses to begin the lesson. So in that way, you have to think and write. In your notebook, free notebook, what you have to do is first in write the activity title, activity 4, and first write one column by the teacher, left side by the teacher, and right side the situation. Here you have to write in the notebook the situation. Here one model sentence, that is all for today. This is by the teacher side. Next, opposite side, situation at the end of a class. How many are absent today? Situation side, to know the strength of a class. In that way. Next, after completing the teacher's side, next, by the student. You have to write by the student, left side, and situation, right side. Again, I was absent on that day. First, this is. You have to write left side, then here situation. So when will that student say I was absent on that day? When the teacher asks the answer, then the student says I was absent on that day, so I don't know answer. So this thing you have to write in the next column, second column. In that way you have to write. Situation. So all these are some expressions used by the teacher, used by the students. You have to write situation. I hope you all understood activity 4. Next. Assignment. Fill in the blanks with suitable expressions. So here, teacher and student Sharif is both are there. So teacher, Sharif, why are you not doing the task? Sharif, sir, blank. Here we have to fill the blank by understanding the next sentence. Teacher, why? I think you had a book with you. That means teacher is saying that I thought you have the book. That means Sharif said, I don't have the book. So fill it with, sir, I don't have the textbook. Next. Sharif. Yes, sir. I had one, but dash. We don't know. Again, we have to go to next sentence. Where is John? That means Sharif gave that book to John. So we can fill it like, yes, sir, I had one, but I gave it to John. I gave it to John. Then teacher, where is it? Sharif, dash today. We don't know answer. Then again, we have to depend on next sentence. Teacher, in that case, why don't you borrow a book from them? So here, why? What I understand is, maybe he is absent. So, Sharif, John is absent today, sir. Next. Jane and Jagan. Instead of that, he can sit here and do the activity with us. Sharif, dash. And we as a group will do that. That means Jagan, Jane, and I. That means here, right? Jane and Jagan. And we as a group will do that task. Next teacher. Okay, dash in 10 minutes. So we can guess that, okay, do it in 10 minutes. Do it in 10 minutes or make it fast in 10 minutes, whatever it is. Next assignment 2. Using the following expressions, develop a conversation between the teacher and the students. It is not necessary that they should be used in the order you find them. Here, good morning, have a nice day, do you understand? So how many tenses are there? That is right. These are not in order, disorder manner. So while you are preparing one conversation, discussion, you should not think it as first sentence came, good morning, have a nice day should be in the first sentence only. Do you understand in the second dialogue? How many tenses are there? This is third dialogue. You should not think like that. You can use freely. You can use anywhere in your discussion or conversation, dialogues. Okay, do it yourself and write it in your notebook. So here, some pictures, commands, related to command. Stand up, next year, open the door, next. Close the door, open the window, write your name, be quiet, take out your notebooks, pay attention, open your notebooks, pick up, sit down, erase the board, listen, silence. Let us practice. Thank you. So this is the end of the lesson. I hope all of you understood very well. If you have any doubt, just note down in your notebook. when I take the class, this class, live class, you can discuss with me, you can ask me your doubts. I will clarify in that class. Up to that, so until then, you have to listen, watch this video, learn whatever I explained in this video, write down activities, assignments in your file notebook, complete it, okay, and get ready for the live class. Thank you very much.